Привет. Hi. I'm happy to talk at Postgres Vision 2020 Virtual Edition Conference. And today I will talk about full-text search in Postgres. I work in Moscow University as a research scientist. I'm a professional astronomer. Also, I work as a CEO of Postgres Professional Company. And I'm working with Postgres since 1995. Here are my project in Postgres. I was working on and still working in some project. My main interests in Postgres are extensibility of Postgres, non-structural data, and indexing. Actually, FTS history is quite long. It's almost 24 years, as I discovered yesterday. I started in 1996 when I developed text search engine for digital archive of Russian newspaper Учительская газета in company Redline. And I was very surprised to discover that Postgres doesn't work with 8-bit characters, Cyrillic characters. So I had to introduce locale support to Postgres. That time I did not understand, realize that that was actually a very important contribution and Postgres become international. And then we start working with Theodor Sigaev on OpenFTS, developing GIST index, tSearch, DSH2, Gene index. And in 2006, full text search was moved to the core. And the last contribution was a room index, which supported by Postgres Professional. But of course, there are more things to improve, to develop, and this I will talk later in roadmap section. So the full text search, people, we understand what it is. It is a fine document which match a query, which formulated on some query language. The notion of document in database is a bit complex because it's maybe materialized document, it arbitrary text attribute or combination of several attributes. It can be totally virtual document, for example, result of complex query, including joins of different tables. So full text search in database is very different from the what external search engines do. People asking why we need a full text search in Postgres built-in, because people can use very fast external search engines like Elasticsearch. Yes, but usually big informational system, they have combination of two search engines for read-only, Elasticsearch for data, for sensitive data, for data who need instant access, consistency. Built-in search engine is very important. So for example, external search engines can't index all documents. They can provide instant search, consistency. It is very difficult to access. They don't have access to attributes, so difficult to construct complex queries, access control. And also the external search engines need to be maintained. And this is a headache for the DBA. But as I said, I always recommend to consider combination of several search engines. In Postgres, we had requirements for full text in Postgres. It's full integration with database engine. That means full text search should support transactions, concurrent access, recovery, online indexing. Optimizer should understand the complexity of full text search operators. We need the linguistic support, the query language, very expressive query language. Also the Postgres should, FTS should support a customization. So it needs a pluggable and customized via SQL commands. And also it should be fast, of course, and scalable. Traditional text search operators in Postgres, you know, all of this, and they all of course can be used for do some simple queries and they work actually, but they have no linguistic support. There is no meaning what is a word, what to index, how to normalize word, or what is stop words. And if you want to return results in some sorted order, you need something like ranking. But all documents equally similar to a query in the text search operators. And they are slow because they need to scan all documents. This slide actually kind of contains the basic, the heart of full text search. All other stuff, all other functions, features, they are just wrappers around these data types and operator to make full FTS more convenient, more fast. But the almost the basic of FTS are two data types and text search operator. We have TS vector, this data type representing the document optimized for search. So it is have a sorted array of lexemes. So we can use binary search. Also, each lexeme has a positional information and labels. Labels, we have four labels, A, B, C, D. A is more important by default. Think about structural information, about importance. If documents consist, for example, from title, subject, keyword list, and body, you can mark words from these parts of document with these labels. And later, when you calculate the similarity to the query, similarity of document, you can take into account the importance of different parts of document. As I said, by default, A is the most important. They have the biggest weight, and then B, then C, and D. TS query is a textual data type for query, which contains Boolean operators and full text search operators, which are between TS vector and TS query. Here's an example of two queries, cat and rat, and cat and not rat. How real life TS vector looks like, I demonstrated on this slide. It's a TS vector of post from astronomy picture of the day with title A Double Conjunction Eclipse. It describes a very rare astronomical event when moon occulted Jupiter and Venus. So we have conjunct lexeme, which is a stemmed version of conjunction. And we see that it has a title position. So you see this the third word in the title. So it has position number 3. And we mark it with label A. It's most important. And then we have keyword part. It's marked by B. In keyword list, it is a eighth word. Then we have two entries in body, which marked by C. So this is how real TS vector looks like. Also, you see that TS vector is sorted by lexeme. TS query can use labels to control search area. For example, the first query is a search supernova and stars, the whole document. The second query, we search only titles. And the last query, we search titles and abstracts, for example. So with one TS vector, you can create many different searches. For this query, we have function rewrite, which allows you to control search at query time without reindexing, without recreating TS vector or creating indexes. For example, you can change, you can rewrite query New York to New York or Big Apple or NYC or Gotham. So you can expand your query. As I said, online, just with, using function rewrite. TS vector and TS query, they can be constructed inside database using the functions and externally. You can create TS vector and TS query, for example, outside of database in Perl, in Python, and then use Postgres as a storage and executor. So TS vector and TS query with the FTS operator are just the building blocks to develop many different custom search engines. And Postgres provides infrastructure for this. It provides FTS configurations, which is a combination of parser and dictionaries, functions to make TS vector and TS query, so you don't need to create them by hand. Indexes to accelerate text search operator, functions for ranking results and search snippets. And of course, there are many, many other additional functions. Yes, but I will not stop on them. So let's start talk about parser. Parser is an essential part of FTS. It breaks text on tokens, and each token has TOC ID, which is a type of token. So we see that there is a function tsparse, which has the first argument is the name of parser. It's a default built-in parser, and the text what to parse. So we parser breaks to the 6 lexemes, and to know what type of lexeme we got, we can use ts token type function, and we see that we have the first lexeme is unsigned integer, the second is space symbols, and then we have hyphenated words and parse of hyphenated words. It is possible, there is a SQL interface to create search parser. The user should provide 5 functions, and you can create text search parser and then use it for full FTS. Another interesting and one important part of FTS configuration is dictionary. A dictionary is an arbitrary function which has API, accept token on input, and return array of lexemes, null if token doesn't recognize, and empty word for stop word. On this example, we see that A return an empty array because A is a stop word for dictionary English handspell, for handspell dictionary for English language, and a plural form of elephants returned just elephant, just one form, and elephant was not recognized by a dictionary and returned null. And the last example is from Russian handspell, we have a word tushy, and TS lexize function returns 4 different forms, 4 different forms. We have SQL interface to create a new dictionary. The first argument is a template name and then options. Templates actually are built-in dictionaries. We have simple dictionary, which just lowercase the token and optionally check for the stop words. Synonym dictionary, and there is a contrib extension of this dictionary called XSYN. Thesaurus template, Snowball stammer, iSpell dictionary, which supports handspell, iSpell dictionaries, an extension unaccent, which removes accent from tokens from word. But user can write own templates and create own new dictionaries, use it. It's fully extensible. So for configuration name, also there is a SQL interface. So the first argument is a parser name, and second argument is a source config. Source config is a configuration, it's a name of built-in configurations. Then you create new configuration, and then you can use alter text search configuration to change the specific options in the full text search configuration. You can in PSQL there are some commands to show all information about configuration, and there is a goods variable default text search config, which is the name of FTS configuration. Currently, a full text search in Postgres supports 22 languages and one simple configuration, and all these configurations can be used for creation new custom configuration, FTS configuration. Here is an example of real life FTS configuration for search system. This system search Postgres mailing list, and we see that we use several custom dictionaries: Thesaurus, Synonym, English and Russian spell dictionaries, and then we use stemming. Synonym is important to use for Postgres mailing list because some people call Postgres as a PGSQL, Postgres, PostgreSQL, Postgres with double SQL, and of course we want that user get all documents about Postgres. The rule is very simple about order of dictionaries. So if the first dictionary is narrow, some specific dictionary like Postgres dictionary, and two common dictionaries. And the last dictionary should recognize everything. It's usually it's stemmer, else the word will not go to the TS vector. So you will not able to find it. This is a link to the real application of searching mailing list, Postgres mailing list. It has a faceted search. It supports strip citation from post, because you know that we have sometimes very long threads. We use PGTRGM for suggestion, and you can specify phrase in quotes. In query language. Here is example how it looks like. So I type server crash and it suggested me several variants. Then I got results for faceted search. You see that in PG general found more than 1,000 postings. In PG hackers found also a lot of postings about server crash. So again, I remind that FTS configuration, it combines parser, which breaks text to the token and talk ID pairs. And each token processed by dictionaries until token is recognized. The set of dictionaries is maybe different for different type of token. If token is recognized, then result saved in TS vector. If token is a stop word, then it discarded. So to facilitate creation of TS vector, to work with TS vector, TS query, full text search provides several functions. To TS vector, converts text to TS vector, And two-tier query, converse query, it's a text with logical operator, two-tier query. It is the better to specify configuration name because it could affect the performance, because with configuration name, these two functions are immutable, and without, they are just stable. So this scheme illustrates how document processed to the TS vector. So we have document, then parser, and each token processed by dictionary until it recognize or not recognize or it stop word. And then we have a loop. Now, example, the first example on this, we use a simple configuration without any stop word. So we see that the result is a sorted array of lexemes with the positions. All lexemes presented here. On the second query, we use English fault FTS configuration, which has a list of English stop words. So we have much shorter TS vector, and also each word processed by dictionary by stemmer. So, for example, story becomes story, and long not changed, true also not changed, and false just E was cutted, suffix was cutted by stemmer. We have a strip functions, which strip removes position from TS vector. Sometimes there is, you know, the positions used for ranking functions, and you don't need ranking. For example, you want to find 10 most fresh postings about supernova stars in astronomy picture of the day, then you don't need, as last query demonstrated, you don't need positions, so you can make TS vector much smaller. You know that JSONB is really popular in Postgres. Actually, I think that invention of JSONB caused the growing popularity of Postgres. If you see that this official data from DB engines, we compare relative growth of PG, of Postgres, MySQL, Oracle, and MySQL, and we see that only Postgres is growing up, and after we committed JSONB to Postgres. So we made support of JSONB in FTS, and 2TS vector can accept JSONB or JSON instead of text, but it converts only string values. And actually the phrase preserved. So on this example, you see the how TS vector obtains from the JSON. And if you obtain JSON or JSONB, the result is looks very different because of JSON is a stored JSON as is with preserved formatting, but JSONB is a binary storage, and it's used it doesn't save white spaces and order keys by length of key and then by key name. So positions are very different, as you see. But if you want to index the whole JSON, I remind you that the 2TS vector index only textual values. You should specify, you should use different function, JSON, JSONB 2TS vector. And the third argument of these functions, specify what to index, key, numeric, or boolean. Here you see the several examples of what you get from the from these two functions. First query, it's what you index, we use 2TS vector, And Tourier TS vector contains only textual values. You see key AA, we have 3 and 4. And key C has value elephants textual. So we have only 3 lexemes in the TS vector. On the second query, we have JSON B2 TS vector and specify to index string and numeric. So we added values from array of KB. And now we have 5 lexemes. And elephant, for example, has a position 5. And the third query, we specify to index Boolean. And we have just 1 true lexeme. If you want to index everything, you can specify all. And we have the longest, the most completed TS vector. Two TS query process the same way as two TS vector, but with one exception that we need to build a query tree. The query tree, we have this example for supernova stars, the query supernova and stars. And we see that they process by dictionaries and supernova becomes supernova. And second form is SN. SN is a scientific abbreviation of supernova. And stars become star. Then we see that query looks a bit more complex. But internally, it the processing is the same. Token ID, dictionaries, check for stop words, and so on. Two-TS query accept text with operators. If you say just logical replication, you will get a syntax error. You have to write logical and replication. And you see the examples of a two-TS query function. The first is just logical and not replication. Well, the second is a phrase search. And the last one is a TS query with specification of search area. And we have wildcard. Wildcard means prefix search. So replic is looking for in area C and search for prefix, match words with prefix replic. Of course, people want to just write plain text as a query. So there is a function plain two TS query, which accepts plain text and automatically create ended query. So logical replication becomes logic and replic. This is just for lazy people, but phrase two TS query is very useful because it converts text to phrase. With phrase is a preserve order. And here an example how the phrase converted to the query. This function very useful when you copy and paste from somewhere and want to search it. So phrase to additional wrapper, there is a web search to test query. It's a Google-like query language which support phrases and or wildcard, plus word, minus word. So people who want to copy search query from Google, this query is could be useful, this function. How to work with labels in TS vector? How to assign labels to TS vector? There is a function setWeight. The first example, we use the version of function with just 2 arguments. The first argument is a TS vector. In this case, it's just word cat. And the second argument is a label. So we have cat with position 1 and label A. The second query, we combine different parts, different words with different labels. And we get a resulting TS vector. So in the same way, you can combine different parts of documents. So just use, instead of specific words, just use the column names. But don't forget about coalesced function. And the last example is we use a third argument, which is contains words and assign to these words the label A. So for the document cat, rat, mouse, we say that mouse and rat should have label A. Let's consider the astronomy picture of the day example. You can download it and play the link in the reference slide. So, and I always recommend materialize TS vector as a column to avoid overheads at runtime. So we have FTS TS vector here, and to fill FTS column, I use this query. So TS set with to TS vector, we use English FTS configuration. And then we use a coalesce function tie to protect TS vector. Because sometimes, for example, if keyword is null, then the whole TS vector will be null. But we want just to replace null by a zero length string. Default values for labels are for labels D, C, B, A in the increasing order are just A is 10 times more important than D. And here is an example of functions, how TS rank CD is a ranking functions. It has argument TS vector and TS query. And you see that for query red in area D and mouse TS query, we get zero because there is no red in area D with label D. The second argument, we got some ranking because red and mouse are exist in the TS vector, and we don't specify any area, any labels. The third query, we demonstrate that we could change the default values for label. This is very handy, very important. You can, at runtime, you can say that, okay, title are not very important for this query. You see that we change from 1.0 to 0.1. So, and rank becomes much smaller. And the last query, we asking for a phrase, red and red mouse. Phrase means that we preserve the order and the distance between words. In this example, this not there is no such a phrase. There is a cat and mouse, but not on the in the same positions. In the same, the mouse not follow the red. To get five most similar documents, we use a function. We can use function tsrankcd with tsrank, and for tsrankcd we get a different result from tsrank because the first function, ranking function, is understand the query language, and tsrank doesn't understand query language. It just used supernode and stars. Doesn't matter and on or and so. So I prefer and recommend to use tsrankcd functions for ANDed query. We have additional functions tsdelete, unnest, tsvector to array, array to tsvector, tsfilter. They are sometimes handy. TS Debug is very good for debugging FTS configuration, TS Start for get word frequencies, TS Parse, TS Rewrite, Headline, and ordering results. I already said that TS Rank just compute the number of occurrences of words. And the bigger rank, good for the more occurrences, the bigger rank. It's very good for OR queries, not good for UN queries, and it doesn't support any query language. TS Rank CD, it's support query language, and the closer words to each other, the bigger rank. And good, so it would, it is good for UN queries. There is another ranking functions. It comes from RAM extension. It's called RAM test, test query. It's a combination of above. So it's the best, but you need an extension. TS headline, we can use TS headline to get a pieces of documents, which illustrates the query. So in this example, we ask a short headline with minimum words numbers of with number of words from 6 to 10. We use a selection and store selection just for demonstrate here, and we're looking for supernova stars and order by rank. No, very handy sometimes it's use a correction suggestion or misprints, and we can use trigram statistics and find words ordered by the number of common trigrams. For example, for this word supernova with one misprint, we have many this number of trigrams. We can collect words from a pod table using test.fong function. We can optionally create gene index from trigram extension just to speed up search, but for demonstration you don't need actually index. And then we can find words ordered by number of common trigrams. So this function similarity returned an operator, similar operator. You see, we find the correct words supernova and pre-supernova, and here is similarity. We can change the default limit of similarity, which is currently is .3. Let's change to .25, and we get two additional results like hypernova and nova. So this is how how to add additional functionality to full text search. Of course, full text search should be fast. For this in Postgres, we use indexing. And we have gist index, which is good. It good in fast insert, but for small collections only, because it's use a special data structure. It's use signature tree, and once the collection is growing, the number of unique words growing, the signature tree just saturated, just degenerated, and index becomes not usable. Gene we introduce after gist is a standard inverted tree used by all search engines. It optimized for storing duplicated keys. It is not as fast as gist for updates, but it has good performance and scalability. So we suggest to use Gene for full text search. And the third extension is a Room extension. It is a Gene plus plus. It's a new generation we develop from Gene because Gene has some problem. We store positional information and some additional information in Gene. And then it calls room. Here's what benefits you get from room index. So it improves ranking performance because we have positions in index and we can calculate rank inside. So we don't need to go to heap read rows and calculate ranking there. So the benefit you will see, 14 milliseconds versus 400 milliseconds. So room is very fast for ranking. If you don't need ranking, you can order, for example, by timestamps. Yes. So you can store timestamps inside a room and use it for ordering. And again, with room, room is much, much faster than Jin, because in Jin you have to, you need two indexes and you need a bit combined search by indexes. In room, you just need to have one index, as you see in explain in plan. You see that index condition and order by insight. That's all. Room also improves phrase search. You know that phrase search use positional information. So if you compare to the simple TS query, Tom and Lane, no, and Tom and follow Lane, we need to check the first. We need to find all documents which contains Tom and Lane, and then check for the positions. So there is a overhead on this table. You see the numbers for sequential scan. It took 1.6 seconds for simple TS query, Tom and Lane ended query. For phrase search, it took 1.7. So overhead exists, but not so much, not so big. With Jin index is faster, of course, but overhead is big. It's almost two times slower phrase search. In room, we have the same speed as Jin for AND query, and almost the same as and minimum overhead for phrase search. So room is very good for ranking, for sort, for ordering by additional by attribute which stored in the room, and also it improves improves phrase search. That's now we talk about FTS roadmap. Roadmap includes we want of course to improve indexing stuff like Jin room. It should be faster creation index, fast insert, parallel support. The next plan is we have flexible full text search configuration, because current syntax is not good for building complex searches. For example, impossible to make a good multilingual search. And there is a link for discussion. I also want to improve dictionary API, so dictionaries can be easily managed from FTS configuration from outside, how behavior of dictionary. Put iSpell dictionary in shared memory. It save memory, and it also it's much faster. Then we thinking about adding TF-IDF ranking function, which is de facto standard for external search engines. Currently, we don't support this. TS vector compression, we want to remove 1 megabyte limitation. So TS vector can be very big. That the time we developed for FTS, introduced TS vector, we thought that 1 megabyte is a lot. Now people store books, long JSONs. So they're asking to remove this limitation and add more labels. 4 labels is not enough. Well, we have prototype, we need to work on this. Also, it's every release, Postgres got new languages. And in PG14, expected languages for Basque, Catalan, Hindi. References, some useful references you can see, and the last slide, all you need is Postgres. I'm Thank you for the attending this virtual conference. Have a good luck. See you sometimes offline.
So unfortunately, Oleg's had some network difficulties, so he's not able to join us to answer any questions. We will pass those on to him. I'm not entirely sure yet where we'll publish the answers, but we'll try and make sure that happens. Regardless, thank you very much, Oleg, and thank you very much, everyone, for attending. Enjoy the rest of the conference.